Oh, okay, this is very nice. Look at that. So we have effectively a servo control loop on this side. There is an AC motor here. And we have various synchro transmitters. So we have three here, another one here, and this is probably a synchro transformer or potentiometer for the feedback. And there is this potted module here. And this board is probably the servo control loop amplifier with the power stage here using these two transistors, a classic 2N3054. Okay, it is written here, servo amplifier. We have a small transformer here and three castanet tantalum capacitors here. And this is probably a transformer, dead code 75. So this is probably used in order to have a duplication of the heading measurement. The input should be one synchro transformer. Maybe this one, I don't know. And all others should be connected to the rear connector in order to be connected to several passive indicators. Three or four, I don't know, at least these ones. So it can be interesting to supply this thing. You just need to find the power supply input. Okay, but we can see that we have a rectifying bridge here. So first what we can do is to apply an AC voltage between these two terminals here. So let's do that first. Okay, I have applied a voltage here of 23 volts AC, and there is a voltage on one point of this transformer here of 81 volts. Okay, so this should be the power supply input, 115 volts. So we can check also the voltage across this filtering capacitor. There is a voltage of 30 volts. The working voltage of the capacitor is 50 volts. Okay, so let's increase a little bit the voltage. So now the voltage is 34 volts, 35 DC. And the input here, you have 28 volts AC. And from the ground to that point of the transformer, there is a voltage of 103 volts. Okay, so we can increase a little bit the voltage. 106. 111. Okay. And there is a voltage of 30 volts AC approximately here. Okay, so I have discovered that the rotor of this synchro transformer, these two wires here, the rotor is connected to two terminals of the servo control amplifier, these ones here. So obviously the input of the amplifier is the rotor of this synchro transformer. So the stator should be connected to the rear terminal, and the stator of this synchro transformer is the input of the servo amplifier actually. So I have found that these three wires here are connected to three terminals, these ones here. So I have connected these three terminals to a synchro transmitter, this one here. So this thing is actually a transformer. This is the AC motor for for the servo control loop. The reference winding of the motor is connected to these two wires, the white and the yellow. And I have found also that these two wires are connected to these two terminals of this transformer. And as we know that the reference winding is 26 volts AC, I have found that these two other terminals here are actually the input voltage of the transformer, that is to say 115 volts AC, and these two terminals are connected to these two terminals here in red. So I have applied an AC voltage of 115 volts AC between these two terminals. Okay, so this is not complicated. Okay, so now let's turn on the power supply. Okay, so you can see that the servo control works. So this thing is just a repeater. The input of this servo control amplifier is normally connected to the synchro transmitter of this thing, this one here. And this permits to have a copy to three synchro transmitters here. So this permits to drive different heading indicators and also an autopilot system. So this thing is maybe a potentiometer. I'm not sure, I don't know. So we should have three synchro outputs made with these synchro transmitters here. And also maybe one potentiometer also. So you can see that without any reverse engineering, it is still possible to do something. The servo control is quite fast and stable. That's the end for this gyro amplifier. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.